But let's go ahead and get to our first guest, shall we?
Let's do it. Let's see how we're going to do today, how we're going to fare today. Dr. Lori is back with us. Lori, I'm loving the setup. We always talk about showing our coffee mugs. I thought I drank a lot of coffee. Lori, we might need to do maybe some intervention with you if that's all filled with coffee right now.
Yeah, well, it's a lot of coffee here, let me tell you. You know, it's a million little things on ABC. It's a million mugs. Don't you all have a million mugs now?
So, okay, quick question though. Are mugs pretty valuable? Like, are they pretty collectible?
Some mugs can be pretty collectible. You know, if there's a mug with my face on it, it's usually pretty collectible. You know, like this one right here. Then there's like Royal Dalton Toby mugs. They can be pretty valuable. Or maybe you've got mugs from your alma mater. This is my Michigan mug. Ha ha, Natalie. Your Ohio State mug by you. People collect mugs.
Yes, they do. I love my mugs. I like them from all the different TV stations I've worked at.
I know. I have a couple of them too. Some of the same TV stations.
All right, well, let's get to dumpster or no dumpster. Again, if you're playing along with us, we hope you are at home. The deal is we have to decide if something should go in the dumpster, if it is worth $50 or less. And of course, I know people now getting those Christmas decorations out. Maybe they're finding some other things tucked away. Well, so let's go ahead and get to item number one.
Number one. Fishing lures. How about it? Fishing lures. The first fish I caught was a rainbow trout. So I didn't use a fishing lure like this. I used a very slimy worm. So you've got fishing lures. These are relatively old. These date to just about 1920 to 1940. And there's a group. So you are going to guess for the group with their hooks.
Absolutely no dumpster, but I feel like I'm cheating. I mean, I've talked with you about this before because, you know, our family is a big fishing family.
Yep.
Can I so be honest for a second?
Yeah.
I didn't know what they were until Corley said what they were.
Natalie.
I'm like,
you were drinking coffee. You were busy drinking your coffee and you weren't thinking about fishing.
I was, and I was like, what is this that we're showing? Like, are they big? What is it from the medieval torture time? I don't know what it was.
It's got how about the double hook? So that poor fish doesn't stand a chance.
It looks terrifying.
Yep.
All right. So this is no dumpster, right? Certainly because there's a couple of them.
Right. Because there are five of them, they are a no dumpster, but you'll be surprised to learn that a 1910 fishing lure, that's not one of these, sold for $100,000 some years ago in an auction. So interestingly enough, people do collect these pretty high. So for this group, you're looking at just about $250 for the group.
Wow.
Yeah. Watch out for those vintage fishing lures. They can be valuable.
Well, and I feel like you just have so many people, unlike Natalie, I guess, that in the fishing community that love that kind of stuff when you can find
and collect that kind of stuff. So if you're cleaning out the garage, you see grandpa's tackle box, don't just trash it, you know?
Now I know what to look forward to. What do we have here?
This is a prestige dinner plate. It's the garden pattern. It has sterling silver banding around the rim, and it is also detailed with blue and pink flowers.
Is there a set here? I mean, one is a little lonely.
7 inches in diameter is lonely. It's just the plate.
Oh. Who did you say makes this?
Prestige makes it. Made in Japan.
Oh. You talked about before that sometimes Japanese and Asian pottery doesn't typically do as well. So with that and the fact that it's a lonely plate, even though it has a sterling silver, I'm going to say close to 50, but not over. So it's a dumpster for me.
I'm going to say dumpster too. I'm not seeing anything super impressive about it yet.
Nothing super impressive about this particular one. What the trick was the sterling silver. So I'm glad that you picked up on the trick. Value on it, $20 for the plate. But you have to look at the marks. You have to know the names. Some Japanese pieces can be valuable, some not. Yeah, Carla.
Real quick. So China, and because I feel like it's not as popular as what it used to be for generations now getting married. Yeah. What say you?
It depends on the China. So, you know, I have seen some plates. I appraised a plate yesterday. I appraised an oyster plate yesterday that was $250 for one plate. So it depends. You know, the Limoges plates from France are usually pretty valuable still. Most people who are getting married now, most of the young women are now saying, one set. I'll take grandma's set or mom's set. One set is all I want. I don't want four or five sets. And from about the 50s to about the 1980s, new brides were getting multiple sets. So they're not doing that anymore. But yeah, okay. But China is still popular and collectible. People like it.
And then where do you store it? Where do you store it? Okay. Speaking of 1 minute, though, we've got our last object.
So 1 minute for the black pearl necklace. So rice pearls is what they're typically called. They are black from, of course, Tahiti and the South Seas, the South Pacific and such. It is 30 inches long. Remember what I told you about jewelry?
No, I don't remember.
No, over my head, don't remember. Okay, 30 inches long is pretty long, right? So you can wear it different ways. If it's versatile, jewelry usually is pretty valuable. And those are black pearls. So, you know, if you had your white pearls, your cultured pearls, these are the opposites of typically black pearls that you'll find usually in places like the South Pacific, Australia, and such.
Well, one thing that I do hold on to, and I probably shouldn't, is jewelry. I have quite a modge podge, so I would keep it, I think, regardless. Amount, I'm not going to throw out a dollar figure because I have no idea. But I would say it would be a no dumpster.
No dumpster, you keep the jewelry. You keep the jewelry, too. Go keep the jewelry and ask for more. Go ahead, Carly. What do you think?
I don't know. Are there a lot of black? We're out of time. I don't know. I'll say
it's
dumpster.
It's a dumpster. It's a 30-inch black pearl necklace. I always show you something good. A value of about $400.
The fishing lures were good.
Yeah, they were good. The fishing
lures. Hey, Carly, if you have other jewelry that you want to throw away because you don't think it's valuable, just send it over this
way. Trust me. I have way more jewelry than.
And then speaking of jewelry, next week I need some hair tips because this is looking bad.
Hey, we got those coming up later in the show, Dr. Lori. Okay.
Speaking of things that are coming up in the show, too, after the break, we're going to be talking with two of the stars from ABC's A Million Little Things. We're going to get an update and a look into season 3. Stay right there. We'll be right back.